The story of this amazing fruit, noni, begins with its most important ingredient, prozerenine, which is a large molecule with two club-like ends. When we drink the juice of the noni fruit, the prozerenine goes through our digestive tract and into the large intestine, where it is then sent into the liver. The liver is the main storehouse for many of the essential nutrients which we take into our bodies. Every 2 hours, the liver should release a certain amount of this prozerenine into the bloodstream, where it is converted to zearalenine, a substance used in protein assimilation. Through the bloodstream, it is transported to various tissues of the body. To understand what happens, it is necessary to move into the molecular level. In order for the prozerenine to be made into zearalenine, the action of an enzyme called prozerenase is necessary. Prozerenine wraps itself around the enzyme prozerenase, and the enzyme joins the two club-like ends of the prozerenine together, cutting off the useless chain. It then combines with serotonin, a hormone primarily produced in the brain, to form an essential molecule called zearalenine. Once zearalenine is formed, it combines with many proteins in the body. These proteins require zearalenine in order to function. There is a specific site on certain proteins that allow them to combine with zearalenine. Many of these proteins are not able to perform any of their duties without zearalenine. Not all proteins require zearalenine to function, but many vital proteins acting as hormones, antibodies, and enzymes need zearalenine. Zearalenine enables the protein to carry out their responsibilities. First, they give structure to hair, skin, and bones. Proteins provide most of the structure of your body, even down to the cell itself. Second, they allow the transport of chemicals within and without the cell, attracting important nutrients and allowing them passage through the cell membrane. Third, proteins also act as hormones in the body. In this capacity, they coordinate all bodily processes at the molecular level. Fourth, they act as antibodies in their support of the immune system. The antibodies attach to foreign bodily invaders, such as viruses, and incapacitate them. Finally, proteins act as enzymes facilitating all chemical production in the body. Our cells are constantly breaking down and building chemical compounds, and it is protein that allows this to happen. Now we understand why prozerenine is so important to our bodies. Knowing that it is naturally supplied to us by the food that we eat, why do so many people realize benefits from the regular use of the noni fruit juice? There are several reasons why the body requires a prozerenine-rich supplement. One of these is the loss of micronutrients from the soil due to chemical fertilization and soil nutrient depletion. Another is poor nutrition, illness, or a highly active or stressful lifestyle. Even aging will place an increased demand on proteins. In order to meet these demands and keep the body healthy, we can increase our supply of prozerenine by drinking noni juice to overcome the effects of low levels of zearalenine and restore healthy protein assimilation. Both plants and human beings use zearalenine, however plants handle unused zearalenine differently. Some plants retain the zearalenine as a means of storing nitrogen that the plant needs to grow. In order to keep the zearalenine in storage while also inactivating it, the plant will add strings and clumps of storage molecules to zearalenine so that it won't break down. Once these storage molecules have been added, it becomes a chemical compound called an alkaloid, many of which form medicines, drugs, or poisons. There are over 10,000 known alkaloids. Some of these include caffeine, cocaine, nicotine, heroin, and morphine. Plants create alkaloids to stabilize zearalenine and retain nitrogen. This works effectively for plants, but problems occur when some of these alkaloids are introduced into our bodies. For example, if you smoke a cigarette, a great supply of free nicotine is released into the body. Although nicotine is inactive in the tobacco plant, it so closely resembles the structure of zearalenine that it fools the proteins in your body. These proteins then accept the nicotine rather than the zearalenine that they naturally want. Once the nicotine is accepted into the zearalenine's rightful place on the protein, even though awkwardly, The nicotine activates the protein in the same way xeranine would, only less effectively. Although the nicotine is able to activate the protein, the attached storage molecules serve to inhibit its effectiveness. If you continue to smoke cigarettes, eventually your body will adapt to the nicotine by slightly changing the shape of the protein so that it will fit nicotine rather than xeranine. This is the molecular basis for addiction. For example, the body will crave cigarette after cigarette, and in the same way that these proteins once needed the xeranine molecule, they now literally need nicotine molecules to function. The more you smoke, the more proteins will be converted from xeranine proteins to nicotine proteins, making it increasingly difficult to quit because more and more proteins are now unable to function without nicotine. This is why withdrawal can be so painful. However, if nicotine is kept out of the body, these same proteins will readapt to xeranine. As this occurs, the physical craving for nicotine disappears and the body returns to normal. This same process applies to all these foreign alkaloids we take into our bodies, as well as others. When these foreign alkaloids are taken into the body, proteins adapt to them and change from their natural need of xeranine to an unnatural need of foreign alkaloids. And as our bodies are flooded with these foreign alkaloids, some of our proteins are stimulated to overwork, thus creating a feeling of short-term euphoria. However, the difference in structure of the alkaloids will either limit or enhance certain aspects of the protein's natural function. The key is that alkaloids are simply mimicking xeranine. Why is it so easy to become addicted and yet so hard to break the addiction? When you first flood the body with a foreign alkaloid, this great supply of the alkaloid in the bloodstream overcomes the smaller supply of natural xeranine, causing many proteins to quickly convert and accept the foreign alkaloids. To reverse the molecular activity of addiction, the body could be flooded with proxeranine in much the same way it was originally flooded with the foreign alkaloid. By doing this, the body readapts to xeranine, and the problems of withdrawal might be avoided. Dr. Ralph Heineke, the original researcher into proxeranine from the noni fruit, theorized that it might be possible to overcome addiction just as quickly as it was created by taking proxeranine-rich noni juice under the tongue once an hour for 3 days. Xeranine's role in the body has many other applications. It acts as the body's supreme pain reliever and anesthetic because it works with endorphins produced in the brain to numb pain and produce feelings of euphoria. Endorphins are the hormones that are responsible for producing good feelings. As we have learned, the liver is the main place of storage for proxeranine. The second major storage place for proxeranine is the skin. Proxeranine is converted to xeranine throughout the body, including the skin. An ample amount of proxeranine is needed to maintain healthy skin, hair, and scalp. By using skincare and hair care products containing proxeranine, skin, hair, and scalp conditions may show marked improvement. We have described only a few applications of an extensive list which can be created in support of the tremendous potential proxeranine supplements could have. Consumers of noni fruit juice have already experienced many amazing benefits that a proxeranine supplement can have on maintaining health and assisting the body to heal itself. By sharing the cultural uses of the noni fruit and the scientific knowledge of how and why we can benefit from a proxeranine-rich supplement, we are making a major contribution to the goal of a healthier world.